My name is Oliver Queen. After 5 years in the house, I returned home with only one goal, to save my city. But my old approach wasn't enough. I had to become someone else. I had to become something else. I had to become the Green Arrow. Previously on Arrow.
I don't know what I'm doing. Where's Walt? Your job is to infiltrate the area and report back.
He's been calling them the ghosts. They're like nothing we've ever seen before. We need the hero.
I'm the one who controls it. What do you people call them? The ghosts? I'm Damian Dark.
Mass murder, killing innocents. I didn't sign up for this.
You signed up to follow my instructions.
And if I don't help you, you don't have a choice.
6 months ago, Nero died. 46 more years. I am declaring my intention to fight for this city.
These ghosts, they keep coming.
We still did a good job today.
Yeah, not good enough.
Hey, can I talk to you for a second? Kind of felt like you were out there for blood tonight.
But you haven't been dealing with these ghosts as long as we have. If I go easy on them, things are going to end bad really fast.
I'm worried that if you keep going the way that you're going, you're going to put one of them down permanently.
I know where the line is, okay? And look, it's almost 9. Mrs. Danforth and Madison are going to be at our house in like an hour, so I have time for one of your lectures or a shower. I pick shower. Everything okay?
You look nice.
My first day back at Palmer Tech. I get to be bossy today because I am the boss of a multi-billion dollar corporation. I know I should be nervous. I know. I'm not. I'm actually really excited.
You should be excited. That's why I got you the first day as a boss, Fern. And patch lunch.
Who are you?
Who are you? Answer me.
Graduate in May with a degree in ancient philosophy.
Ancient philosophy? What happened to your dream of being JT's backup dancer?
That's still plan B, obviously.
It is so lovely to see you, too. Really, it's been far too long.
No, Thea and I were glad you got in touch.
Yeah, we were a little surprised, though. Well, I admit that reconnecting with the son and daughter of one of my dearest friends is not the only reason that I wanted to see you.
And here comes the crazy.
Last week, like the rest of the city, I saw the Green Arrow's broadcast, and it hit me. If that man could take up the Arrow's mantle, I could take up your mother's.
How?
By running for mayor.
See, I told you. Crazy.
No one's opposing me, obviously, but it's only to be an election.
There's a very good reason that no one else is running.
Yeah, the last 3 mayors have been killed.
To say nothing of the city's leadership last week.
Which is exactly why we need a mayor more than ever. I want to step forward. And I'm asking for your support.
Wow, You guys look bigger than you did when you were on my computer screen.
Perhaps we should begin with this quarter's financials.
Thank you. Okay. I know I don't have a business degree or an accounting degree or an MBA, but this looks very, very bad.
These are hard times for everyone in Star City. This company's not immune. Fortunately, Mr. Holt has devised us a way out.
Oh, goody.
Hello. I'm actually not a member of the board. I work in the design innovation department.
Tell Ms. Smoke about your algorithm.
It's pretty simple, actually. I use specialized AI to determine maximum profits, which can be derived with a minimal amount of workforce reduction. Sorry, I probably could have explained that better.
No, I got the gist. You came up with a list of people that you'd like me to fire.
Workforce reduction has a nicer sound to it. It just kind of rolls off the tongue.
Yeah, well, the only thing we'll be reducing is all of your bonuses to start.
We've already been down that road and exhausted all other avenues, Ms. Smoke.
I didn't come back to this company to put the people who work here out of work. I came here to protect Ray Palmer's legacy.
And if we do not dramatically reduce our costs or increase our profits, there won't be a legacy to protect.
Why do you only want to have the best feelings about this? I mean, signing up to be mayor of this town is like asking to be part of Titanic.
Or you heard me try to talk around running.
I'm pretty sure that got covered up. Let me tell you how we beat her.
Ladies and gentlemen,
for the past 6 months, the mayor's office at City Hall has stood vacant, waiting for someone to step forward on behalf of Star City. And today, I am here with all of you to tell you that I am stepping forward. 2 years ago, I lost my good friend, Mara Clee, who was also a candidate for mayor. And I remain inspired by her kind heart and her selfless devotion to this city.
You can touch Jessica. I've got this. Shots are just a distraction! Don't post up here!
Whoa, whoa, wait. You're not in her detail. Get back to the agent!
Over.
Self-defense class.
And 2 seconds later, someone's trying to kill her. That must be a record even for our city.
And she's not dropping out of the race, so this isn't over.
My father has a protective detail on her.
Yeah, but even with protection of the announcement, she didn't seem to be too safe.
Is this just me, or is the shooting of a potential city leader feeling a little ghosty?
I wasn't wearing a mask.
There was something else different about him. He left behind evidence.
Fingerprints.
How'd you get the owner to part with his windshield?
I bought his truck. It's one of the benefits of your girlfriend inheriting a multi-billion-dollar conglomerate. We have money now.
I don't exactly think that was money well spent. I don't think these prints are going to do us any good.
What the hell?
I'm not an expert, but I think our new friend may have cut off his fingertips and played a little bit of mix and match. I'll keep digging. Maybe this is an MO that'll tell us something.
In the meantime, we backstop the SCPD. Thea was right. Jessica needs more than the police can offer.
She's in protective custody, and I'm pretty sure my father wouldn't be in favor of us staking out his precinct.
I'll talk to her.
Oh, yeah. That'll definitely go over well.
This is Danforth. He's under our protection 24-7 until this nut bar is in cuffs. Give me a minute.
Got your TV debut. Guess you decided to stick around.
It's going to be different this time.
Yeah, sure. Well, because you got a new name now, right? With a color. Green Arrow. Gotcha.
Jessica Danforth is a friend. We would like to help keep her safe. With everything the city's facing, I thought you could use all the help you could get.
You've been gone. You don't know what this city's facing. I mean, I'm not saying it doesn't need saving. But a guy hiding behind a mask isn't going to get it done. What this city needs is someone willing to stand up in the light of day, not a guy lurking around in the shadows. And you say you're going to be different this time, huh? How?
Thank you.
You're late.
I know. Sorry. I was looking at the numbers again.
Oh, you mean the numbers of people that your magic downsizing algorithm is making us fire today.
Downsizing? You think I did...
Let's get one thing straight. The only person who is allowed to talk in sentence fragments around here is me.
I developed my algorithm to create a value matrix, to argue for company-wide pay increases, raises. Mr. Dennis turned it around and had me use it to figure out who to fire.
So this wasn't your idea?
I was trying to get people to get paid more, not pay nothing.
Hi, I'm Carla Groves. My supervisor asked me to come see you.
Hi. Yes, I don't know quite how to say this.
I'm fired.
But clearly you do.
As rumors go, downsizing ones tend to go viral.
I am very sorry. I didn't come back here to put people out of work, but I am hoping that by losing a few jobs, I can save many, many more.
That looks like a little more than a few.
Yes. The company is going through a difficult time.
I know. And when we heard you were coming back, we thought things were going to get a lot better. Guess we were wrong.
Still hungry. Is it wrong that I'm still hungry? John.
Shift changes in 10 minutes.
You know, for the past week, you've been pretty intense. Are you going to tell me what's going on? And don't tell me it's because Oliver's back.
Well, I'm not happy Oliver's back.
Yeah, you weren't exactly subtle about that.
Just let it go, Laura.
No, because we don't keep secrets, remember? John, what's going on?
Well, last week, when Oliver was telling us about Dark, he said he had a hive of followers. An organization called Hive killed my brother.
I don't know. Do you think it's some kind of coincidence?
No. I've been looking into this organization for 2 years now. All dead ends. But when I did manage to dig up tracks of what we know about Dark's ghosts, they're Hive.
Do all of our listeners know?
No.
You've been investigating this for 2 years and you haven't told me.
It's a family thing, Laura. I don't think you of all people understand keeping secrets when it comes to the death of a sibling.
I do. And because I do, I can tell you, carrying a burden like that, it never ends in any way with that.
That was quite the show. False machine gun, impersonating a bodyguard. You have the flair for the dramatic, Mr. Machen. I will give you that. Too bad it was all for nothing. Half of your fee has been wired into your account.
This isn't about money for me.
Oh, I know. You came to me with promises. You wanted to impress yourself to my organization, and you failed.
I'm not done yet. Just give me more time. I will make sure that Jessica Danforth does not run for mayor.
Very well. I want a word of caution. I'm not sure how Rick Pinzola runs his operation, but Hive does not believe in third chances. Good night.
Spoke to Deagle. No movement at the precinct.
That's all right. I may have some movement here. I noticed something tacky on the palm print our guy left on the windshield. Tacky? Like a residue.
What kind?
Cellulose. Oh, except this formulation is special. The molecular structure's been patented.
By who?
Palmer Technologies. A subsidiary, actually. Palmer Paper. I had to shut down the mill a couple months ago to talk to the
measure. Where's the paper mill? Hey, stay sharp. Hey, some sort of electricity weapon. The man in the photo. You seen him?
I don't see much. I like my sleep. But that guy, he sees a lot. He deals out of here. Does a lot of business.
Hey, we need to ask you a few questions.
Step off, freak.
You seen this guy here? I'm wondering.
You masks. You think you're in charge? Yeah, well, maybe you were, but not anymore. There are new masks in charge.
Let me ask you. Have you seen this guy here? You still want to use your arm?
Let him go.
Still think you're in charge?
Hey! Get out of here!
I got an ID on her, Mr. Creepy. I thought his fingerprints were all screwed up. Mixed up, but I have an obsession with jigsaw puzzles. Lonnie Machen, part-time mob enforcer, full-time crazy pants. Done jobs for the Brunellis, the Triad, Rick Pinzolo.
We're gonna talk about this We're going to have a conversation about what just happened.
What just happened was I had information and I was trying to get it out.
He broke his arm.
He was stalling.
He was scared.
Come here. What are you doing?
I'll show you something. At the water plane, you took down a ghost. You could have done it with a very simple disarming technique. Like this. Thea, that's not what you did. You went overboard with a series of techniques designed to do one thing. Cripple.
Oliver?
It's fine. After Roz hurt you, Malcolm warned me not to take you to Nanda Parbat. He said that when people go in the pit, they don't come out the same. And I didn't tell you because I didn't want to worry about you. You seemed normal, Thea, and I swear to God, I thought everything was going to be fine.
And then you left. So you know what? It doesn't really qualify you to judge me or anyone else. What's going on? What happened to Thea and Nanda Parbat?
I did what I had to do. Save my sister.
Well, that was 6 months ago. Why is the pit only affecting her now?
It's probably been shutting up over time. So
what do you want to do about it?
I guess we know what happened to Kenny.
Donald!
Just shut up.
It's a minefield. Right? That's what killed your friend.
Who the hell are you?
My name is Oliver Queen. 3 years ago, the yacht that I was on went down in a storm. I washed up here. I survived.
Let's take him to Ryder. He'll know what to do with it.
Wow, you look like someone who has to fire her home as people today.
What? Oh, no. I mean... Yes, but this isn't about this. Not that firing a dozen people is going to do much for my mood.
Actually, it's 24.
What?
The pages are double-sided.
But there has to be another way. This many intelligent people in the company. There has to be someone who...
Mrs. Smoke, are you all right?
Absolutely.
It's okay.
What is it?
I'm on the list, aren't I?
I'm so sorry.
It's okay. I mean, it's one less person that you'd have to fire today, right? You know, actually, this is good news in a way. My husband will be thrilled. And this way we can take that trip that he's been wanting to go on. Of course, I'll have to drive.
You don't have to try and make me feel better about this.
About what? I sort of fired myself.
Want to visit me in my confinement?
Thought you could use some company.
Oh, I told you so.
Oh, I didn't bring it. With that being said, it's not too late for you to drop out.
And send what message? That on top of the city's other problems, we give in to terrorism? The people here deserve better. They deserve someone to be brave for them.
That's what the Green Arrow's for.
It's not enough. Yes, the Green Arrow risks his life to keep the people of the city safe, but who inspires them? You know, who works to make sure that there's a city worth saving? Who's there to make Star City a place that my daughter wants to call home?
Where's Madison?
Library. Poor kid, it's fine. Also, send her back to school. Don't worry. Captain Lance sent her with more than enough cops to keep her safe.
Maybe you should call her.
To the man who took my daughter, please. I'm begging you, please let my baby go. She's all I have. She's my whole world.
Killed the officer who's schooling her with some kind of weapon, shot up her 5 miles off all slit his throats for good measure.
His name is Lonnie Machen.
Do I even want to know where you got that intel?
You can't do this alone. You know that. Now two of your guys are down. Now let us help.
Where's this place? Over there. Barrett, this guy says he's...
Oliver Queen. You don't recognize him? This man's a minor celebrity on the other side of the world. He's supposed to be dead.
Well, he was. Thank you for rescuing me.
I'm sorry, but we're not rescuing you. First thing you do once you get home is tell people what it is we're doing here.
I don't know what you're doing here.
Be that as it may, I can't send you home. Not right now. Good news, though, I've no reason to kill you.
So what are you going to do with me?
Good question. You survived 3 years here, all alone. That requires fortitude, intelligence, qualities that are of use to me. As it happens, one of my men stepped on a landmine. How would you like his job?
Thanks for coming on such short notice.
What did you do? Where is Jessica Danforth's daughter?
Did you catch the news earlier? Miss Danforth begging for her daughter's life. She'll do anything to get her back or not do anything. Like run for mayor. All I have to do is make a phone call.
Now I see why Rick Gonzalo banished you. You're unaware that there are lines one does not cross.
I met one of your ghosts. After I took his tooth, we had an interesting conversation about Hive. I wasn't led to believe you respected lines.
I respect order, Mr. Major. Discipline, precision. You, you're sloppy. All you represent is anarchy. You made a mess. I suggest you clean it up. Either way, our relationship is concluded.
Wait! You can't.
You know your hand is on me.
Are you okay? Just can't stand watching Jessica go through that. I feel like that's what my mom felt like when Slade Wilson abducted me. That's not what you asked, though. I'm fine.
Well, you could have fooled me.
Thea, what happened to you and Nanda Parbat?
Ollie didn't tell you.
It's Ollie.
Well, I guess I really am his sister since I didn't tell you either. I just didn't want to relive it.
Relive what?
Raj, yeah. He killed me. Or almost did. Ollie said that it was pretty bad. And then Raj offered to use something. I don't know, to bring me back. Something he calls the Lazarus Pit.
Wait, so what's happening to you now is a side effect from this pit.
Malcolm tried to warn Ollie, I guess, but he didn't listen.
No, of course he didn't. He would do anything to save his sister.
I swear, there was even a scratch on that girl. So help me.
I'm afraid that is out of my control.
Yeah, well, so am I. I am out. I am all the way out.
Well, I suppose you need a reminder that Madison Danforth is not the only vulnerable daughter in the city.
You stay the hell away from my daughter, you son of a bitch!
Language.
Precious.
The location of the Danforth girl. My sincere threat against your daughter notwithstanding, this abduction lacks taste. The next time we meet, make no mistake, there will be a next time. Remember to mind your tone.
Any news?
Only the bad kind.
Right. We're going to catch this guy.
Yeah, and when we do, there's going to be another one waiting for us. And another. It's like the most depressing game of whack-a-mole ever.
Can't say we didn't know what we were getting into. Back into.
We decided to stay in Starling. I mean, Star City. I was excited. I thought it meant a new beginning. And now we've only been back a week. John, still mad at you. Thea's gone pig crazy. I've spent the last 2 days putting people out of work.
If you think that we made a mistake, we didn't. Nothing worthwhile ever comes easy. We said that we were going to do things differently. We just need time to figure out how. Captain?
Heavy Club, Forth and Pierce.
What about it?
It's providing mention of Jessica Danforth's daughter.
Jessica, don't think it's differently now.
Here's a chance to prove it.
Sorry to leave you hanging. I had a meeting. Didn't go well.
Turns out, I can't fit at the cool kids table.
When trillions and trillions of molecules exploded from a pinhead, were there rules dictating how to establish a universe? No. They found their way through the chaos.
Please, you can still let me go.
Only if you promise not to tell anybody about me. Think you swear? I changed my mind.
You're working with the Felicity. This is why I need a code name.
We have Madison, but he's split.
There's no movement outside the club. He must still be in there with you.
She needs medical attention.
Get her to safety. We've got this. Hey, can you handle this?
I'm good.
Really sorry, but I got an army of reporters out there, and they want to know if you want to make a statement.
Yes, I'll be out in a few minutes.
You don't have to do that tonight.
Yes, I do, Oliver. I have to tell them what I've decided. I have to tell them I'm withdrawing my candidacy. I'm not running for mayor.
Thank you for trusting me.
You aren't kidding about doing things differently, were you?
Instead of pin cushioning guys, now you're burning them alive.
Captain, and you're lucky Major is on his way to Starling General. I'll be booking you for murder. Just so you'll see where we stand with each other.
This man needs some water. Did you hear me?
Yeah, I heard. Get back to work.
What are you going to do when all your workers are dead from heat stroke?
Not your concern. Like the man said, get back to work.
Miss Smoke, what's this we're hearing about you halting the workforce reduction? I thought we agreed.
But you talked and I listened. I would hardly call that an agreement. With that said, I did get around to firing a few people. They've all been hired back, BT Dump. And one of them reminded me that Ray Palmer never would have approved of this.
Ray Palmer is dead. And this company will be too.
I am going to stop you right there.
Sorry, Miss Smoke, you asked to see me. I think there's been a mistake.
No, actually, you had perfect timing. I was just about to tell Mr. Dennis about your project. After I fired Mr. Holt, I had the opportunity to review his active projects. Turns out he is working on something that is going to revolutionize technology and save this company. neither of which he can do with a reduced workforce supporting him.
Intriguing. So what's this revolutionary technology, Mr. Holt?
That is proprietary. But I can assure you it will astonish the world.
Our annual shareholders' meetings in 6 months, presented there. Astonish us.
Oh, we will.
You don't even have an idea for some world-astonishing technology, do you?
Nope, but I'm betting that you do.
Pretty bold move, Miss Smoke.
Yeah, well, I'm trying to do things a little different.
Hello? Hey. How are you?
I guess I was wrong when I told you not to worry about me.
Right or wrong, I'm still going to worry. It's right at the top of the Big Brother job description. Thea, I should have told you about the pit immediately. That was the old me.
And who are you now? Ollie 2.0?
No, more like Ollie 1.0, who's trying to do things differently. Look, whatever you are going through, we will get through it together.
I thought Thea could use some time out of town. A spa getaway. Clear head. As long as it's not near any hot tubs, because that's what got me into this situation.
I think it's a good idea.
Can you and John handle things while we're away?
Yeah, as long as we don't kill each other first. Bye. I'm kidding, by the way. We'll be fine. Probably. Take care of her, okay?
I like a spa as much as anybody, but I think we both know whatever is going on with me will not be fixed with a mani-pedi. That's why we're not going to the spa. We're going to Nanda Parbat. Yeah, whatever's going on with you, believe you'll know what to do. Why are we not telling my brother? Because you're not the only reason for us going to Nanda Parbat.
To make the Starling General. Try to get the paramedics on the radio, and we got a 911 call reporting this. Lee-Chin, I don't really know how to describe what he did to him. Sure, send them in.
It means anarchy.
Hello.
Hey, I'm out here.
You look happy. Tell me you started enjoying firing people.
No more firing. Good. Figured out another way.
Well, maybe you could share your secret with me. Doing things differently is what I promised myself.
You are doing things differently.
Not different enough, apparently. Both Lance and Jessica Danforth said something to me about the city needing something that the Green Arrow can't offer.
Decent sushi restaurant?
Hope. Inspiration. Someone who can do things in the light, who isn't afraid. Someone who could protect himself. This week. I'm going to run for mayor.
Move your head.